my dream was a reoccurring dream. And it seems to last for quite a while. It seems at least for a good week, 2 weeks almost. And
some of my reoccurring dreams are like from like years, months ago.
Yeah, well, mine was like two weeks in a week. You know, every night it'd be a part of that. But one of the things I remembered in my dream is that there was a confrontation. And there was always somebody being threatened by someone with some weapon. And the confrontation was, is this person was aimed to kill. And I would protect that person by jumping in front of the person. And I would get stabbed, or I would get shot, or I would get hit.
Interesting.
And I never could understand why am I stepping in front of this person. Who is this person? I couldn't see the person, but I knew that person was related to me. So, and it was close to me.
So interesting.
So I figured, well, maybe it's a brother, a sister, a family member. It happened, you know, maybe it's my kids or what, I don't know. And it kept happening. The scenario was always different, but the message was always the same.
You're going to die.
So the bottom line is, whether this guy's attacking this person with a gun, I'm going to step in front of this person to protect. I'll get shot. If it's a knife, I'll get stabbed. If it's a bat, I'll get hit. In. He's a famous actor, and he played in a spy, you know, and first, you know, he's sitting in the chair, and on top of them, somebody shot him, killed him, because in my dream, he was still a spy, even though he was an actor, and I remember, I'm talking to him, and I'm chasing him, hey, you're all right, and he was dead.
believe it was from late 60s, early 70s. Yeah. This is one of hers. I'm not sure what this is all about.
Wait, what? You know what that is. You're weird.
These are Christmas favorites.
Yeah, you gotta love those.
And then you got a lot of rock and roll. He called me, he's threatened to come here, and it was like 1, 2 o'clock in the morning. Come home, I haven't seen him, and he finally called, and I told him he needs to get his butt here, and blah, blah, blah. Now he said he's coming over my friend, and they're going to beat me up. Every time he'd see me, he'd be nervous, because he knew I wouldn't put up with any crap from him. And that's who should die. That's how I made the connection. That's who he was.
Oh.
Where you're doing more triplety thing rather than a shuffle, like is less cool, I reckon.
Thank you.
if you mean by incurable, then it has to end.
Yeah.
And it's incurable.
But you've known that all your life.
Of course.
So what's different?
What's different now?
Yeah.
Now the probability of its ending is upon me. Very, very short order. I'm 78.
All right. So even if you were as healthy as could be,
I still would have.
Once you get to be 78 years old, you consider the reality of death.
Absolutely.
Here's Cheap Trick.
Yeah, Cheap Trick at Buddha Camp. That was one of my favorites.
I'm not sure if you can see that, but whatever.
This is Old Cruise in 1958. I brought that because that was the year I was born. So this is what the music that was going on.
There's a variety of different types of music from the 70s.
Oh,
Gypsy, like Tramps, and Thieves, Mr.
Oh, I see Cher.
Dr.
Horton
is really good. Donny Osmond's good. These are all Eric Clapton.
Oh, I like Lil Eric Clapton.
Yeah.
Hello, commercial watchers.
Beatlemania. That was really good, Beatlemania. Beatlemania was basically a remake of some of the Beatles songs. This came out back in the, I believe it was in the 70s as well. 70s or 80s. Bad Company.
Elvis.
Aerosmith and Queen.
Yeah.
One of my favorite bands.
What the heck is this? Power Play?
Yeah, those were all real popular. Yes, he listened.
I'm fine.
Right. The sky was white, the sun was shining, it was a beautiful dream in the dream, but I knew something had happened, so something, and something did happen when I, later on, and I realized that dream was to show me that something is going to happen, but everything remains the same, and it's still a beautiful day, and it's all good. Big speakers. I mean, they were as high as almost that TV right there.
From the floor down.
To that, and I had the big turntable. Then I had the disc, the
cassette deck with that.
Were these handmade?
Yep, some of them were. Yeah, some of them I made. Some
that
of them
looks.
Are. Some of them I bought.
Been like 6 days since I saw it.
Commercial watchers, we're here at the La Choy Chow Mein Kitchens to show you a sensational visual demonstration.
Oh, I'm a sensational visual demonstration.
This is the lovable La Choy Dragon.
You tell him, baby. I quick cook La Choy Chow Mein in dragon fire, like so.
Music from the 70s, and the songs are anything from the 60s on up.
It's pretty nice.
David Clark's five greatest hits, they're good. Great song in this album. Then, of course, we get Puff the Magic Dragon.
Whatever that is.
Maybe we don't want to know what they were puffing in the old dragon. country I'm not as much. Some of them go okay.
Yeah, new country,
I love
like
the
that
old
rock
country,
country.
The old whiny ones, you know.
Yeah.
Like, nah, 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 you know, like that type of thing. This is the guy that says, hey, banana boat song.
Remember we were at the AC, Anonymous Clown?
Okay.
That is in your closet?
He is in my closet.
And I go there, I'm talking to him, he's not moving, and I pull the chair closer to the door. And I'm yelling for help, and I'm trying to get him, and then I wake up. And when I go to work, that place the next morning, that chair is where it was in my dream.